next to fool this town. I'll do it till the sun goes down and all through the night time. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I'll tell you what you wanna hear. Keep my sunglasses on while I shed a tear. It's never the right time. Yeah, yeah.
Hello and good afternoon. My name is McKenna Conley, and it is my honor and privilege to welcome you all to Gateway's Spring 2022 Nurse Pinning Ceremony. I want to start by extending a very warm welcome to our Gateway President, Dr. Brian Albrecht, our Dean, Dr. Victoria Coyle, our Provost, Zena Haywood, and our Program Chair, Renee Seymour, as well as to all of the board members and Healthcare Advisory Board members who are able to join us today. Thank you for being here, and thank you for everything you've done for this program. It feels quite surreal to be standing here before you today and acknowledging that this day has finally come. But it's here, we did it, we're done. On behalf of myself and all of my fellow graduates, I want to thank all of the family and friends who have taken the time to be here with us today, especially those who were poked and prodded while we practice all of our new learned skills. We really appreciate all of the sacrifices that you have made during the course of this journey as well. All right. To all of our instructors who have worked tirelessly, not only today, but to just help all of us be successful in this program, I will forever be grateful to all of you. I'm confident that every person that walks across this stage tonight to finally be pinned would agree that this was a very hard-earned moment. It took a lot of hard work and dedication. We all fought to be here. Through the hours of reading, the endless concept maps, gallons of tears shed, an exorbitant amount of nursing videos, constantly updating our CETs, and the studying until it felt like our brains would literally hold nothing more. This is the beginning of a whole new chapter, and it was worth it. I think back to orientation, stressing over the number of hours that they said we would have to study each week, or that first skills assessment that was like pages long. It made me question everything. I don't know about you guys. We have slowly accomplished each skill and competency that was required of us until a list of things left to learn was shorter than the list of things left in our learning objectives. We slowly became baby nurses, and I am so very proud of us. Whatever it was that caused you to choose this profession, whatever your why was, it got you this far, so keep it close as we start our new careers and finally put everything that we've learned into action. When the days bleed into nights and you feel tired or overwhelmed, remember why you chose this, remember how hard you worked for it, and remember your why. As nurses, we're going to be in a unique position. We get to be with people during some of the scariest and potentially worst times in their lives. We will not be able to fix every situation, but we do have control over how we interact with each person. We can be a light in that dark time. We will treat them with dignity and respect, and we will ensure that they are cared for. It's not only our patients that we're going to be able to impact, but it's also each other. Nursing is a team effort, and if this group of graduating nurses is any indication of the team that I'm joining, I am proud to be a part of it. Now, as we move on to the NCLEX and starting new jobs, this is it. This is what we've worked so hard for. Your perseverance has finally paid off. When you get stuck, just remember to ask yourself, what would Florence do? And assess, assess, assess. Now onto the well-deserved pinning ceremony that we've all been waiting so long for. Thank you and congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Melissa Ninkovich, and I have the honor of introducing our school's President and Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Brian Albrecht. He has held this prestigious position for the last 16 years and has accomplished so much for our school and communities. In his tenure here, he has established a national leadership position in the development of innovation learning strategies, model business and industry partnerships, and community engagement. Dr. Albrecht has also served on many distinguished local, state, and national boards. Dr. Albrecht holds a bachelor's, master's, and education specialist degree from the University of Wisconsin-Stout and a doctorate degree from the University of Minnesota. His experience has led him to testify before the U.S. Congress on workforce issues and as an invited speaker at the White House. Dr. Albrecht has been recognized as a distinguished educator by the International Technology and Engineering Association, as well as a distinguished citizen by the Three Harbors Council of the Boy Scouts of America. And most recently, Dr. Albrecht has presented the Distinguished Leader Award from the National Council on Career and Technical Education. Under his hand, Gateway was able to build the Inspire Center that has groundbreaking nursing simulations to guide students to strive for excellence. He welcomes innovation with the ultimate goal being student achievement. Please join me in welcoming, for one of his final nursing pinning ceremonies here at Gateway, Dr. Brian Albrecht.
Wow, thank you so much for that kind introduction, Melissa. And McKenna, great job. I'm always so inspired by the students when they get in front of a big stage like this. And this is an important occasion to have a big stage because we've got some great graduates here today. So when you were walking in this evening, I noticed that you have a new walk-up song. If you follow baseball, you know that they play a song before every batter comes up to bat, and they get to pick that song, and that's their walk-up song. So I was sharing with some of the faculty, and they said, you all picked that. And I can't think of a better walk-up song than Unstoppable. You certainly are. We are so very proud of you. So a little secret here for all of us. I know we're at Journey Church, and sometimes when you're at church, you're supposed to be a little quiet, but not tonight, okay? Let's all give all of our student graduates another big round of applause and a big, yeah, yes. This is their day, but it's also your day. I know we've all been on this journey together, and it's so great to have everyone back together and to be here on a beautiful afternoon to celebrate our pinning ceremony. It's a little bittersweet for me because it is probably my last pinning ceremony in this role right here, but I will always be a big fan and hopefully be able to come back and watch many more graduates complete their programming here at Gateway. We were just reminiscing a little before the program started. Just this year alone, we believe there are 170 nurses pinned through Gateway Technical College. That has to be one of the largest nursing graduates collectively anywhere in the state of Wisconsin, if not across the Midwest. But this is such a unique ceremony. It's unique, it's special for so many reasons. You're going to hear some amazing stories of our students as they've gone through this journey. Many of you have felt those stories being there to support them as they've traveled down this road. But it is more than an event, and it's more than a ceremonial, traditional experience. It's symbolic of a student who has crossed a unique bridge, the bridge where they go now from a student to a professional nurse. It's an acknowledgement of the coursework and the clinical commitment that you have all made. That is very unique. There are only a handful of professions that have that special designated experience for their students. I can think of emergency medical services where they do a unique program, law enforcement where they do a unique program, but the nurse pinning program is probably the most unique, maybe because it has such a rich history. Actually, it started in 1919, so a very long time ago. And it was a recognition at that time, not a pin, but a badge. When a badge was given to a nurse who was competent to perform service within their community. And now today, of course, we call it a pinning ceremony. And these ceremonies happen all across the nation in schools that offer nursing programs. Each one is a little unique in the way that it's set up and designed. I'm sure they all have unique walk-up songs as well, which is great. It started back in 1860 with the original recognition of Florence Nightingale. I'm so glad that she was recognized already today, and she will be throughout the program. She is the pioneer in nursing, as you probably all know, and was awarded the Red Cross of St. George for her service during the Crimean War. So nurses have been an instrumental part of the history of our nation and of course in the evolution of our society. So we must value that and honor it with all the dignity that it deserves. The pinning ceremony is that statement, that recognition. Now what's unique about it is that tonight we get to also recognize the resilience of each of our students. And not only has the journey been a challenge, because it is probably the most academic, rigorous program that we offer, not only at Gateway, but in higher education. There's so much content that needs to be learned, and it must be applied nearly immediately. There's no time to say, I'll learn it later, or we can practice next week, because as you know, when a patient is lying in front of you, you must recall and demonstrate that compassion immediately. So throughout your nursing journey, we celebrate you that you have demonstrated the highest professional integrity to become a nurse. You've also excelled in excellence in your academic knowledge and skills, and you've established and identified to your faculty the humility to care for others as if you were caring for your own family. That's what defines a nurse differently than any other profession. A combination of that academic intense knowledge that you now have and will continue to grow in your profession. The ability to give of yourself as if you were caring for your own to strangers that you have never met before. And of course, the integrity of being a nurse, always, always doing the right thing. And for that, we are grateful that you've chosen this profession, and we're honored that you chose it to be through the Gateway Technical College family. History, I'm sure, will tell us about this resilience as we go through time. Even if you think just about this last journey that you've been on, some of you for 2 years, 4 years, 6 years, we'll learn tonight, some a very long time, that you've survived and you've thrived in one of the most demanding professions. During a global pandemic, let's not forget that, and probably the biggest test of all, was the adaptability of the learning styles that you were expected to be able to adjust to. The competencies and skill requirements to be a nurse never changed. The way you had to demonstrate them did. That makes you an even more resilient nurse than any of the nurses we've ever graduated here at Gateway Technical College in the past. And I know that your faculty will tell you that you've pioneered new ways of learning, even at Gateway. What you've helped us demonstrate will thrive in the new learning styles that we've adapted. A couple of them you've had a chance to experience. The Inspire Center with human patient simulation, hybrid learning, virtualization, online, just in time. So many different ways in which you've been able to adapt to that. And even during all of that, you still had to do all of your different practical exams and skills labs exams. You just had to find new schedules in order to make it work. So it is a grateful night for all of us. And so while we're here tonight, not necessarily to celebrate graduation, but as a testament to your commitment to make a difference in your chosen's life work, that in itself will live with you forever. And I know even when you're not on shift, that someone in your family or your neighbors or someone at soccer practice for your kids will know you're a nurse and expect you to have all the answers. So you've chosen a profession, a way of life, a life's calling. And that, again, helps us think differently about the work that you do. And so as mentioned, I'll be retiring from Gateway this fall. Puts me down many memories. I think I sent Vicki a note last week. I believe it's my 39th pinning ceremony. Every one of them very unique and very special, to the point where we have 7 nurses in our own family. I honor and value the ceremony that you're going to go through tonight, but most importantly, what it represents. If you take a look at the symbolism behind me, that's our nursing pin here at Gateway. Nursing pins are different at every college. In fact, they're designed by the college. But what's the same, no matter where you are, whatever hospital, clinical, doctor's office, wherever you're going to be working, is that your fellow nurses will also have a pin. And it will tell all of us, you now in your fraternity and sorority, that they have gone through a similar journey. So often said, the best way to experience something is to walk in someone else's shoes. You have all walked in the same shoes. They might look different, but know that as a collective profession, you have strength. So for my journey, I take away some really fond memories, because I know that my success at Gateway didn't happen alone. just as yours didn't in your beginning, your profession. It will take your family, it will take your colleagues, it will take, yes, a lot of people in the community to rally behind nursing. And I'm so glad that our communities are starting to recognize and value the importance of nursing, and you're getting higher compensations, and I'm sure everyone in this class got multiple job offers already. So recognition is a part of that. And I want to recognize tonight, it's a surprise for her, she's in the audience, someone that I've been on a journey with at Gateway Technical College. I'd like to ask Vicki to come up first, and we're going to do an honorary pinning ceremony for you. Zena Haywood is the Executive Vice President and Provost for us at Gateway Technical College. Zena and I have been together since I started at Gateway some 19 years ago. She is your biggest fan. Zena is responsible for the academic integrity of all programs at Gateway Technical College. That's a lot of responsibility. She's also responsible to make sure that the program stays accredited at the national level, making sure that all the competencies are met, the equipment is in place, the faculty hold the certifications. We don't always get a chance to thank her for her work. So tonight, Zena, we are recognizing you with an honorary nursing pin. If you could please join us at the stage. And as Vicki presents the pin, we all celebrate your career, Zena. Zena will also be retiring this year. In a few months, her and I will celebrate commencement at Gateway Technical College, and then our journeys will take separate paths. But Zena, we wanted you to know that we are so proud of what you have done to help build the Gateway Technical College nursing program. A brand new human patient simulation center opening on the Racine campus, a brand new LPN center, the Inspire Center, which has been a model of excellence for so many years, record number of graduates in the program, celebrating an expansion of healthcare careers in multiple areas on all of our campuses. Zena, thank you for your so many years of service supporting the nurses here at Gateway Technical College. Uh-oh, I got the waving finger. I know what that means, I'm in trouble, so I'm gonna get off the stage now. But before I do, I wanna say on behalf of the Board of Trustees, our administration, our faculty, and our entire staff, and should I say the entire Gateway community, congratulations on your pinning ceremony. Thank you, everyone.
Hello. My name is Allison Seneca, and on behalf of myself and the other faculty and staff of Gateway Technical College Nursing Program, I welcome you tonight. I just want to say thank you to Brian and Zena for all their years of service. They will both be greatly missed at our future pinning ceremonies, but I'm sure they will always be with us here in spirit as they've been great supporters of our nursing program. I'd also like to say thank you to all of you. I know you'll be thanked tonight by these now soon-to-be graduate nursing students, but we know that all of you have taken time both today and the past couple of years to support them, so we thank you for that. Will the graduates' last name Arendt through Fugati please present to the stage? Lara Angelica Bacosmas. Lara is being pinned by her mother and father. There are many people I would like to thank for supporting me in my odyssey to become a nurse, my instructors, my friends, and my family. To my instructors, thank you for guiding me in the direction of what is the most correct answer, especially in the select all that apply questions. To my friends, thank you for picking up my many FaceTime calls and crying along with me. Finally, I'd like to thank my family for their constant encouragement, support, and love that they have given me throughout my studies. Student Nurse Lara, signing off for the last time. Peace out. Don't fall, Laura. Mark Beckwith. Mark is being pinned by his twin sister Jordan and his nephew Mikey. Mark would like to thank his family for always putting up with him and being a great sense of humor. I don't know about that, Mark. Mikey for his infinite love of all things hospital to keep him going. The group for the study sessions and laughing at his bad jokes. And of course, Carissa for dragging him along the whole way. Jacqueline Beyer. Jacqueline is being pinned by current fellow nursing student and former nursing student, now RN, Francisco Villanueva and Haley Oscar. To my family, thank you for being supportive of me and giving me so much love and understanding through the craziness of nursing school. You've held me up, motivated me, and reminded me constantly that I can do anything I set my mind to. You've kept me sane and lifted me up every step of the way. To my two best friends I've met along the way, thank you for being my rocks, my cheerleaders, my shoulders to cry on. We've grown so much then, and I'm so grateful to have grown through all of it with you. To the A&P amigos, we did it. Saray Beck. Saray is being pinned by her fiance, Justin. I first want to say thank you to my fiancé because I couldn't be here if it all weren't for his support in every way during the past year. You've made a stressful journey as good as it gets, and I'm very fortunate for that. To my parents, your support is always unwavering, and the help you've provided me does not go unnoticed. And to the group, in capital letters, thanks for a great couple of years and never-ending study sessions. Crystal Cesario. Crystal is being pinned by her daughter Aubrey and her husband Tony. Going through this intense journey has really shown me how much I am loved by so many. I have had to sacrifice many things during nursing school, but one thing I was not lacking in was love and support from everyone around me. From holding me while I cried to cheering me on or even just listening to me, I have every one of you in my life. I dedicate this accomplishment to my dads, Rich and Steve, may they rest in peace, and to my husband, my daughter, and to myself. Thank you for believing in me. I love you all. Kylie Christensen. Kylie is being pinned by her sister, Kinsey. I want to thank my friends and family for helping me through this journey. This has been one of the most challenging things I've done. You are all my motivation. I couldn't have done this without you guys and all of your support, and you have helped make my dreams a reality. Lara Kaufman. Lara is being pinned by her fellow nursing student and friend, Michelle Leindecker. Thanks to my husband and family for all their support and encouragement. And to Michelle, Wes, and Brittany, thanks for making nursing school so much fun. McKenna Conley. McKenna is being pinned by her dad, Billy. Walking across this stage is quite surreal. I think back to orientation when they were telling us before we knew it, we would be here. Yet it still hasn't sunk in that we are finally done. I cannot begin to thank those who helped me get to this point. God, my family, my fish farmers who became my family, my teachers, Angela, Jody, Emily, Marianne, and Sonia. There's no way I can't leave out Nurse Sarah and all her videos. As I look back, I know I will carry these memories with me forever, not only through my career, but my entire life. Even though this is the end of an era, this will not be the last time I'm accused of being rowdy and hard to settle, but in the best of ways, right, Mary Kay? Madison Covelli. Madison is being pinned by her parents, Angie and Rich. I would like to give a special thank you to my loving family for always supporting me along the way. My mom, my dad, my younger brother, for picking me up when it felt impossible to continue. I could not have made it through nursing school without them. Special thank you to Susan Willing for her impact on my education during my time in the nursing program. The lessons I learned from you are the ones I will carry on throughout my entire nursing career. Not all angels have wings, some have stethoscopes. Whoops. Amber Davis. Amber is being pinned by her husband, Chris. Where's all the kids, Amber? As I walk to the stage, each step I take is a thank you to those who have been with me on this incredible journey. A special thank you to my husband, our 8 children, my fellow fish farmers, and the amazing instructors. Say yeah, Timmy, I made it. It is a blessing to be here with gratitude and a promise not to change my answers. I look forward to serving our community as a registered nurse. Danielle Doonan. Danielle is being pinned by her dad, Robert. I want to thank my family, friends, and cohort for sticking by my side throughout this journey. I appreciate all of you and the support you have given me. You may probably think you didn't do anything special, but you made this journey easier with all the compassion and strength you've given. Thank you to everyone who pushed me to strive and succeed, even when I wanted to give up. Your encouragement does not go unnoticed. The instructors and staff, thank you for sharing your incredible knowledge and skills you have taught. I can't wait to continue my journey in the nursing field. Philip Eclairinal. Philip is being pinned by his beautiful wife, Kim, who's also a registered nurse and a Gateway graduate. I dedicate this to my son, who picked the best nights to keep me up when I had a test the next day. To my beautiful wife and parents, who were the best support system through my nursing school struggle. Finally, to the group for all the stress, laughs, and late night Zoom sessions. Nicole Fugate. Nicole is being pinned by her parents, John and Tracy. I want to thank my family for being the best support system I could have, for understanding why I couldn't be at all the family functions or the amount of time I spent away studying. I couldn't thank you enough. Mom and Dad, thank you for pushing me to finish this journey and to keep going, because you believed in me when at times I couldn't believe in myself. You are all my biggest blessing, and I couldn't have gotten through this without you. Will graduates last name Gallo through Leindecker please present to the stage with those who are pinning them? Caitlin Gallo. Caitlin is being pinned by her stepson, Lex Fountain. I would like to first say thank you to Lex because school has taken a lot of time away from us and messed up plans we made. You have handled it so well and have been so understanding. To JD, thank you for being my rock, my cheerleader, and both the best and worst mock patient that I could ask for. Congratulations on vicariously finishing nursing school. Mom, Dad, Grandma, Tutu, and the rest of the brood, I could not have done this without all of your love and support. You have helped me on this journey in more ways than you know. And finally, to Grandpa and Papa, I wish you were both here to see this. Okie dokie, on to the next chapter. Did she say yes? I didn't know if we were under attack or what. All right. McKenna Gunn. McKenna is being pinned by her already husband, Quentin. To do what nobody else will do in a way that nobody else can do in spite of all that we go through. That it is what it is to be a nurse. I want to thank my family and most importantly my husband for being my number one supporter through the emotional roller coaster that is nursing school. I love you more than words express. I also want to thank my children for being my motivation to achieve all my dreams. I'm excited to finally be closing the chapter of my book and moving on to the next chapter with this hard-earned RN behind my name. It's not the first time. Laura Gunnifson. Laura is being pinned by her husband, Andrew. Thank you to my husband and kids for being so kind, loving, and patient with me. Stress was high and patience was low. To my parents and sisters for always encouraging me. Finally, to my friends I made here. We have been therapists, support group, and each other's biggest cheerleaders. Elizabeth Handel. Elizabeth is being pinned by her husband, working on it. Sorry, Elizabeth. This dedication is for my husband, who has inspired me from day one of meeting him, since the day we met. Accomplishing what seems like such a long goal happened only with his consistent support and care for my success. Thank God for him and all of my blessings. Allison Hansen. Allison is being pinned by Alan Gleiss, her partner. I would like to thank my friends and family for your unwavering support. Thank you to my daughter for your patience as I spent so much of my free time studying or at school. My dream would not have been possible if it wasn't for any of you. Alicia Haas. Alicia is being pinned by her sister Angel and her grandma. Thank you so much to my family and friends who helped me push through and reminded me often of how great I am doing and of the light at the end of the tunnel. Jessica Hawthorne. Jessica is being pinned by her husband, Andrew. I would not be here today without the never-ending support of my family and friends. Thank you to my parents and father-in-law who watched my kids for me so I could focus on school. Thank you to my husband who has dealt with me being on a roller coaster ride of emotions throughout the program. To my kids, thank you for your patience on the days I couldn't give you all the cuddles and time I would have liked. I love you all so much. Athena Hernandez. Athena is being pinned by her son Isaiah and mom Barbara. There are so many people that have supported me in my journey to become an RN. I would first like to thank my mom who prayed with me through nursing school. To my son Isaiah, thank you for dealing with my endless meltdowns and late night study sessions. To my study group Laura, Allison, Sam, and Emily, thank you for being my biggest support, encouragement, and cheerleaders. Finally, thank you to my instructors for a guiding path to becoming an RN. This has been a long, bumpy ride, but we did it. Emily Holbus. Emily is being pinned by her husband, David, and all those little children. I'd like to thank my family, especially my husband, for being my rock throughout this entire journey. I could not have accomplished this without you and your ongoing help and support. To my daughters, Mommy won nursing school. Thank you for always cheering me on and believing in me. And thank you to all the lifelong friends I have made throughout the program. Congratulations, graduates. We did it. Nicole Alyssa Holst. Nicole is being pinned by her parents, Brian and Trisha. I dedicate to my parents for encouraging me to pursue my dreams in unconditional love and supporting me in more ways than I can ever thank them for. In this ever-changing world, the one thing that has been constant is my big, crazy, incredible family. I dedicate my success to my son, Finn, my biggest motivation and inspiration. You are mommy's anchor, and everything I do for us. Now we can have enough money to go to Disney World whenever we want. I praise God for hearing my prayers and giving me the strength to overcome every challenge that an obstacle I have faced. Now I can live out my dream. Carissa Jupp. Carissa is being pinned by her sister, Alyssa, and all those little ones. I would like to thank my mom and my sister, Casey, for supporting me through all of nursing school, the group for all the laughs, the late night Zoom meetings, and of course, for putting up with my sassy attitude 10% of the time. But most importantly, I would like to thank my biggest support system, my sister, Alyssa, for dedicating all her time to help me with my children, all while she had her own busy life to attend to. I could not have done this without you guys. Oh. Sukhman Preet Kaur. Sukhman is being pinned by her husband Jay and her father and mother-in-law. I want to thank my family, my in-laws, for their love and support throughout this. Thank you to my husband for always believing in me when I didn't believe in myself, letting me know that I can do it, and to remind me that hard work pays off. I'm sorry about my mood swings when I was stressed out. Thank you for understanding when instead of being with you, I was always studying. Thank you to my study buddy and now lifelong friend, Caitlin Arndt, for her continuous support. I would also like to thank our tutor, Anna, the walking textbook, for helping me through this journey. Samantha Coleman. Samantha is being pinned by her sister, Rebecca. I would like to thank my friends I have made throughout nursing school for always supporting me and each other, my instructors for always being there to help, my family for being patient while I was stressed, and mostly my grandpa for always believing in me and supporting me even when I didn't believe in myself. Michelle Leindecker. Michelle is being pinned by her husband, Jason. I would like to thank my husband for always supporting my chaotic life choices, who pushed me to study when I didn't want to, picked up my slack when I had school, and for never letting me give up on my dreams. I also want to give thanks to my entire family for supporting and believing in me throughout this roller coaster of a ride through nursing school. I couldn't have done it without you. Will the graduates with the last name Lord through Peterson please present to the stage with those who are pinning them? Erica Lord. Erica is being pinned by her husband, Jim. Thank you to my friends, family, coworkers, and instructors for the endless support, encouragement, and flexibility with their schedules. A huge thank you to Jim and Brianna for the continuous support, understanding, and patience in every aspect of my nursing journey. Cassandra Lubke. Cassandra is being pinned by her mom, Pam. I would like to thank my mom for being my constant during these extremely rough few years. She encouraged me when I said I can't and cheered me on to the next obstacle with each passing grade. I would not be standing here today without the unconditional love and support from my parents, my boyfriend Mike, and my amazing friends along the way. Thank you is not enough, but thank you from the bottom of my heart. Brittany Lumley. Brittany is being pinned by her sister-in-law, Amy, a fellow nurse and Gateway graduate, and her daughter, Charlotte. Thank you to my family for encouraging me and supporting me through nursing school. It's because of you that I am now able to support my daughter and myself on my own, and it means so much to me that you've supported my decision to pursue a career that I truly love. Thank you to Charlotte for letting me study and learn how to be a nurse. I love you more than anything. Michelle Lundquist. Michelle is being pinned by her husband, Eric. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for my husband, Eric, encouraging me to prove to myself that I was more than capable of earning a degree. He is my eternal encourager. He and our kids, Amber, Autumn, Bjorn, and Sven, gave me the motivation and strength to persevere through all the mental stress that nursing school brings. They all deserve all the credit for the sacrifices they made so that I could study and do well. Without their support, I wouldn't be standing here today. Amy Lyman. Amy is being pinned by her husband, Mark. It has been a long journey to get to this stage today. I would not be here today without the love and support from my husband, Mark, my parents, sisters, and of course, my cats. Their encouragement has kept me motivated through all of the nursing school. The support from my teachers has been essential to my success, and I am so grateful for them. All these people have helped me to pursue my passion of becoming a nurse, and I am so lucky to have them in my life. Sarah Mentek. Sarah is being pinned by her dad, Gary, and her aunt, Sandy. First, I want to thank God for the strength and endurance to get through this journey. To my daughter, Lydia, who has been loving, patient, kind, and my driving motivation to be successful. I also want to express my gratitude and appreciation to my family, friends, and everyone who has helped me and blessed me along this way. God bless you all, and thank you. Those pins are tricky. Lane Nellison. Lane is being pinned by her son, Dominic. Oh no, and her husband. It's true that I would not have made it through this gauntlet known as nursing school without my friends, family, and instructors, but I especially would not have made it without my son, Dominic. Through his encouraging words of suck it up, buttercup, and only losers give up, helped me get through many a drawback and be where I am today. I am forever grateful. Here's to you, Dom. Thanks for always having mom's back. Well, good thing you're a nurse now. Right. Carolyn Nichols. Carolyn is being pinned by Kevin and Kathy Nichols. I would like to thank my parents for teaching me to work hard and persevere. Thank you is a very small phrase to convey my gratitude towards you, but I am still using it to say how grateful I am to be raised by you. I've seen you both demonstrate strength, compassion, and dedication all my life, and I hope to carry those traits with me. I want to thank you for believing in me, even when I didn't believe in myself. Melissa Ninkovich. Melissa is being pinned by her husband, Mike. I first off want to say thank you to my husband for pushing me to go back to school and complete my degree. I want to thank my kids, Katarina and Victor, for understanding why Mama hasn't always been around to snuggle as much, but don't worry, you'll get sick of my snuggles now. I want to thank Mickey for helping because we couldn't have made this work without you. I want to thank my parents for pushing me to reach for the stars. I want to give a big thank you to some instructors who did not look down on us, but talked to us on the same level as them, Chris, Jodine, Suzanne, and Emily. I am so grateful for you all. Thank you. Brittany Norton. Brittany is being pinned by her mom, Chrissy, her grandma, Carol, and her sister, Brianna. Thank you to my family for always believing in me and never letting me give up. To my mom for being my biggest supporter, I wouldn't be here where I am today without you. Nursing school was not easy, and I am happy to be able to say I did it and close this chapter to begin my career as a registered nurse. Jediah Paris. Jediah is being pinned by her boyfriend, Dominic. From the bottom of my heart, I would like to say thank you to both my and my boyfriend's families for all their love and support. To my boyfriend, Dominic, who has been my biggest supporter since day one, thank you so much for believing in me and always being there for me, getting me through the toughest of times and never letting me get despaired. I could not have done this without you. Emily Paskovich. Emily is being pinned by her twin sister, Elizabeth. I would like to thank my family and friends for supporting me throughout nursing school. I am thankful for all the friends that I have made throughout this program and for all the fun that we've had. I am glad to be done. Congratulations to everyone. Taylor Paulson. Taylor is being pinned by her father, Chad, and accompanied by her mother, Jamie. I would like to thank my family for their love and support throughout my life and throughout nursing school. I couldn't have completed this journey without you. I would like to give a special thank you to my husband for his daily love and support, along with the sacrifices made to make my dream come true. Congratulations to my peers. We did it. Wesley Peterson. Wesley is being pinned by Sue Peterson. I would like to thank my friends and family for their continued love and support throughout my nursing journey. I would like to say a special thanks to the nurses in my life, my mom, Alexi, Anna, and all of the other amazing ICU nurses that I work with. Will the graduates with the last name Rodriguez de Santiago through Williams please present to the stage with those that are pinning them? Rocio Rodriguez de Santiago. Rocio is being pinned by her sister Araceli. I would like to thank my family for always supporting me throughout this journey and always believing in me. and I want to thank my sister Araceli for always being my number one supporter and my motivation since day one. Cynthia Ruiz. Cynthia is being pinned by Melina Madralas. To my wonderful mother that has always pushed me to pursue a degree, throughout this journey, your support and motivation have given me the strength to finally reach my goal of becoming a registered nurse. Thank you for never giving up on me, for all your love, sacrifice, and persistence. I love you, Mom. Gracie Schiesel. Gracie is being pinned by her dad, Michael. And it looks like maybe mom, too. I would like to express how grateful I am for my parents. My father has been an amazing support during my academic journey. He was the number one person who encouraged me throughout all the trials that nursing school has to offer. My mother offered wonderful emotional support to me going through both school and life. She's been a rock, especially in our recent times. I love you both so much. I would like to thank God for guiding me down a path that has led me to success. Lastly, I would like to give thanks to myself. I woke up day in and day out to put the hard work in that made it possible. Now here I am at the end stage before you all as college graduates and soon to be an RN. Madeline Schwartz. Madeline is being pinned by Todd and Julie Schwartz. I want to thank both of my parents for continuing to support me throughout my nursing journey. You have been there for times I needed you most, and words can't describe how grateful I am. I also want to thank my sisters Bailey and Amanda, my boyfriend Jeffrey, and the rest of my family for putting up with my constant excuse of, "I'm sorry, I can't, I have to study." Thank you to the instructors here at Gateway for providing us with a great education and answering all of our constant questions. Through the ups and downs and the constant exam stress, I can say I finally did it. The encouragement I received from everyone around me will never go unnoticed, and I can't wait to put my education to good use. Danielle Chambeau. Danielle is being pinned by her husband, Stephen, and Mason and Aaliyah, her kids. I did it. Thank you to my family for all the love and support that you have given me, even when I was crabby and stressed. Also, thanks to my kids and my husband for being patient, my patient, so I could practice my skills. Thank you to my grandparents, parents, and in-laws for always sharing and helping with the kids so I could make this happen. Stephanie Sima. Stephanie is being pinned by her mother, Christina, also a faculty member here at Gateway. I would like to thank my family and friends for their support and influence on my path towards becoming a fellow RN and encouraging me in this next career stage. I am grateful for the instructors I have had and the patients I have had been able to provide care for. I would like to dedicate and thank my fellow paramedics to RNs as we encouraged and helped one another to further our careers and enjoy the experience. And lastly, thank you all in the audience for being present to experience this pinning ceremony. It is very appreciated. Taylor Simek. Taylor is being pinned by her parents, Lisa and Jay. Thank you to my family and close friends for constantly supporting me through the worst times and the best of times. I couldn't have done it without each and every one of you. Rachel Small. Rachel is being pinned by Austin Young. I'd like to thank my mom and dad, stepmom, and my sisters, Yaya and Abs. I love you all so much. Thank you for always believing in me, even when I did not. Lastly, I'd like to thank Austin. Thank you for loving and supporting me through my academic journey. I could not have done this without you. Coda Steinable. Coda is being pinned by Ken Riley. I was told you find out who your real friends are during nursing school with all the stress and busy work that comes along with it. And this is true, but I also have gained the best ones, who I will forever be grateful for and all the memories we have made. Thank you, God, for this opportunity, and a big thanks to my fellow fish farmers, my amazing family, the father of my unborn baby, and this man pinning me today for loving me and supporting me through it all. It would not be possible without any of you. This experience reminds me to remain humble and kind, but also rowdy and hard to settle. Paige Stisco. Paige is being pinned by her father, Gary, and Parker, her stepson. This has been such a long journey for me. I know, Paige, I've seen you for the whole time. And I couldn't have gotten through it without the people in my life. Thank you for always supporting me and sticking by me through the ups and downs of nursing school. I told you I would never give up. Jenny Swanson. Jenny is being pinned by Jeff Krautwurst. I am grateful for this day, for the lessons I have learned, the gifts shared with me, and the opportunities the future will bring. I promise to do my best as a nurse for those who are in my care. Jordan Vasquez. Jordan is being pinned by her dad, Jesse. First, I wanted to thank my mom and dad for always supporting me in my wildest dreams. I would like to thank my partner, Adam, for encouraging me in my hard days and praising me on my good ones. Lastly, I would like to thank all the friends and family I've made along this journey. I couldn't have made it without each of you. Congratulations to everyone getting pinned today. Our hard work has paid off, and I can't wait to start my career in nursing. Francisco Villanueva. Francisco is being pinned by Jackie Beyer and Haley Oscar. You might remember them. We started nursing school together and we all made it. I cannot believe I had the privilege to meet y'all and get to know you both and have all our adventures together. Even though we all work in different healthcare settings, I know our friendship will keep us together. I hope whenever you all see an egg, you will think of us studying together. And last but not least, Kiara Chantel Williams. Kiara is being pinned by Patricia Williams and some littles. To my family, you have not only pushed me, but supported me into becoming the mom, woman, and now nurse I am today. I truly thank you for not giving up on me, but more importantly, not letting me give up on myself. For that is, this is us, for us, my loves. Whoops. Good job, guys. And that concludes the dedications for this evening. Thank you for your patience.
Good evening. My name is Caitlin Gallo. Tonight, I have the esteemed honor and privilege of introducing our Dean of Nursing, Dr. Victoria Coyle. Dr. Coyle began her career by obtaining her ADN from the College of Lake County. Continuing in her educational pursuit, she followed this with her bachelor's, and master's as a clinical nurse educator from South University. Her thirst for knowledge was not yet satisfied, and yet she then went on to earn her doctorate of nursing practice in 2018 from Grand Canyon University. To further summarize her impressive resume, Dr. Coyle sits on the executive board of the Administrators of Nursing Education in Wisconsin, is a certified health simulation educator through the Society for Simulation in Healthcare, and holds active memberships to the International Council for Nursing and the American Nurses Association. As Gateway faculty, she was the recipient of the 2016-2017 President's Faculty Excellence Award. She has traveled internationally to Belize on two occasions for international service learning programs and to Switzerland for a global enrichment program. She took on the role of Dean of Nursing in 2017. It is through this role that she continues to have one of her greatest impacts on the future of nursing, providing support and ensuring the education of students as they move closer to their goal of becoming nurses. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to introduce you to Dr. Victoria Coyle, Dean of Nursing.
Good evening, everyone. This evening, I have the honor to lead the future nurses in the International Pledge for Nurses. The International Pledge for Nurses is a modified version of what we used to call the Nightingale Pledge. It's a declaration of ethics and principal standards for the nursing profession. It's similar to the ANA Code of Ethics, and it provides nurses with the roadmap for professional responsibilities and conduct. Although it's been adapted over the years, it's very similar. According to the American Nurses Association, the pledge was named for Florence Nightingale. She's considered the founder of modern day nursing. In the pledge, nurses promise to uphold the Hippocratic Oath, to do no harm, practice discretion, and be dedicated to their work as a nurse. This reflects your transition from student to nurse. As I prepared for pinning every semester, I reflect on my own oath, my promise that I made 25 years ago, to do no harm, practice discretion, and be dedicated to their work as a nurse, the same pledge you will make today. Most of us remember our pinning ceremonies even better than we remember graduation. I can remember how it felt when we recited the pledge during my pinning ceremony. Today, I'm going to ask that, first of all of our graduate nurses please stand. And we can give them one last applause by themselves. But now I want them to kind of take a look around, because I'm going to ask all of the practicing nurses that are in the audience to please stand. And then I'm going to have all of the retired nurses please stand. Where are they? I see a few in the back. All right, now I'm going to have you join me in the International Pledge for Nurses. So I'm going to have our graduates take a look at their programs. In full knowledge of the obligation I'm undertaking, I promise to care for the sick with all the skills and understanding I possess without regard to race, creed, color, politics, and social status. I will respect at all times the dignity and religious belief of the patients under my care, holding in confidence all personal information entrusted to me, and refraining from any action which might endanger life or health. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge and skills at the highest level and to give loyal support and cooperation to all members of the health team. I will do my utmost to honor the International Code of Ethics, applied to nursing and to uphold the integrity of the registered professional nurse. I'm now going to ask Renee Seymour. Renee is a nursing faculty member and our incoming program director to come on up and lead us in the blessing of the hands.
I want to say something first before we read the blessing. I want to say that now your hands have very important work to do. Your hands must work in such a way that shows patients and patients' families their individual needs are very important, their uniqueness is highly valued, and that your hands are competent, trustworthy, and compassionate. Your hands will save lives in emergency rooms, intensive care units, Flight for Life helicopters, and combat support hospitals. Your hands will deliver babies and relieve acute pain. Your hands will care for people at their most vulnerable state after a debilitating stroke or a disfiguring surgery. Your hands are going to be working within the most trusted profession of nursing and must be responsible, accurate, steady, strong, altruistic, and merciful. Your hands might be the only hope or the only nurturing touch. Because of all the work your hands have to do, it is a tradition for healthcare workers to ask for a special blessing. Graduates, join me in reading the blessing of the hands. Blessed be the works of your hands, O Holy One. Blessed be these hands that have touched life. Blessed be these hands that have held pain. Blessed be these hands that have rocked the cradle. Blessed be these hands that have tended gardens. Blessed be these hands that have closed in fists of anger. Blessed be these hands that have planted new seeds. Blessed be these hands that have harvested ripe fields. Blessed be these hands that have cleaned, washed, mopped, and scrubbed. Blessed be these hands that have become knotty with age. Blessed be these hands that have wrinkled and scarred from doing justice. Blessed be these hands that have reached out and been received. Blessed be these hands that hold the promise of the future. Blessed be the works of your hands, O Holy One. Congratulations.
Good afternoon or evening, everyone. We got here in the afternoon. I guess it's evening, huh? What a great day we are having together, yes? I'm so glad that we're all here. My name is Jenny Swanson, and I am honored to have the opportunity to present these words of encouragement on this wonderful day that is our pinning ceremony. Now listen, this is important. My mother, for whom I wear this cardinal, Ruth Swanson, who was an amazing nurse for many years, taught me that when we are given a gift, we ought to say thank you. Being thankful acknowledges that which is good in our lives. It keeps us in a positive place, something to remember when times are hard. What gifts are you thankful for today? We are surrounded by people who have helped us become graduate nurses at this moment. So our thank yous go out to our teachers and our mentors, our families and our friends. Maybe you had a preceptor who made a difference. Maybe it was an encounter with a patient that will stay with you for a lifetime. You may even, like me, have a nurse in whose footsteps you now follow. Take a moment to thank them. And if you can, tell them how they helped you. I know that they will appreciate this. To all of our leaders who have inspired us, we are truly grateful. And now I have a question for you. What did you learn on your journey to this day? Now, we learned a lot of nursing theory, and we learned how to manage our time and prioritize. We learned how to write CETs, an important life skill that we will carry forever. Though what I really challenge you to consider here is this. What did you learn about yourself as you accomplished your success? What did you learn about yourself? The successes of our lives are built step by step, moment by moment. It seems like it takes forever when you are in it, a mountain path filled with obstacles, and then in a blink of an eye, it's done. You've worked hard to be here. You never gave up, even when you wanted to. You pushed yourself despite your own insecurities and every voice in your head that told you you couldn't do it because you weren't good enough. And you started over a million times and you kept going. You did it! All of it, every single little bit of it. Celebrate that, savor it, and claim it and make it a part of who you are going forward. We're gonna need it. But you see, it's not just for us. All those people that we thanked earlier, they climbed mountains too. And their support for us is proof. They got through it and shared their success with you. They smiled and they shared wisdom, guided us with a firm edge when needed, and showed us how to do more than we thought we could. And that's leadership. Having those gifts now, you can be the kind of inspirational leader that passes on good energy and supports others on their journey. Why is that so important? Because there are people who you will meet who are beginning the road that you just traveled, and they need you. They need your gifts. They need your encouragement. They need your ever-building wisdom. And they need you to smile and to help them believe that they can do it too. That is how great nurses are made. Let us remember to help each other and to build one another up toward success. As much as we are thankful to those around us, we ought to also be very proud of ourselves. You may not have noticed, but I'm one of the older ones in our classes. To my less aged classmates, I claim it, by the way. Thanks for helping me with my electronics when I needed you. And reminding me that you are younger than my children. Honestly, though, it's been a joy to get to know you and to learn the many roads that you have taken to get here, how your tenacity got you through hard times that I have never faced, how your passion for helping people kept you motivated to do what was right. Having already raised my family, I tip my nurse's cap to all of you who completed this schooling amidst family challenges, raising children, and caring for parents. You are an inspiration in overcoming adversities that made you even stronger of heart and mind than you already were. I am really proud of you. Stand on those accomplishments as pillars of strength. Carry them with you for the ride to come in our first years of being RNs, and take everything that you learned and apply it to make you better. I applaud you. Many of you know that I was a preacher for 25 years. But even so, I'm going to wrap this up now. About 40 years ago, I memorized a poem that stuck with me and has pushed me through moments I wasn't sure I could conquer. You need to hear this poem. In 1881, a man named Edgar A. Guest was born in England. He moved to America as a child and worked his way through school, worked many jobs, and raised a family. During his lifetime, he wrote over 11,000 poems about life and getting through it. His words have pushed me beyond what I thought I could do, including the last 3 years of nursing school for me. I want you to have these words as a way to push through, to recognize your strength, and to do so with grace and a smile. It Couldn't Be Done, by Edgar A. Guest. Somebody said that it couldn't be done, but he, with a chuckle, replied that maybe it couldn't, but he would be one who wouldn't say so till he'd tried. So he buckled right in with a trace of a grin on his face. If he worried, he hid it. And he started to sing as he tackled the thing that couldn't be done, and he did it. Somebody scoffed, "Oh, you'll never do that. At least no one ever has done it." But he took off his coat and he took off his hat, and the first thing you know, he'd begun it. With a lift of his chin and a bit of a grin, without any doubting or quit it, he started to sing as he tackled the thing that couldn't be done, and he did it. There are thousands to tell you it cannot be done. There are thousands to prophesy failure. There are thousands to point out to you, one by one, all the dangers that wait to assail you. But just buckle right in with a bit of a grin. Take off your coat and go to it. Just start in to sing as you tackle the thing that couldn't be done, and you'll do it. Class of 2022, we did it! Thank you, everyone, for being here tonight. This concludes our pinning ceremony. If you would be so kind to wait here while we graduates exit the auditorium, we will meet you in the lobby very soon.